Dear AS and A-level M1 students, hi again. We are in Dynamics Part 7. And I wish you are watching the previous videos and seeing mechanical problems in mechanics could be handled and you understand what are you doing. We are today in the pulley problems, in the particles connected by a string passes over a smooth pulley. Pulley is the wheel shape, this shape pulley that carries two particles like this. All of you know the pulley. We have cases, as we had cases in the nature of motion according to the given diagrams in the previous lessons. We have also variant cases of motion by a pulley. First case, we have a fixed smooth pulley like this, and the two particles hang freely, hang vertically, these two particles. According to the mass of the particle, according to these values, dear students, we write the equations of motion, as I explained here. Remember the most important thing, writing the equation of motion properly and correctly. So you are given in the first case, M1 is more than M2, mean M1 is heavier. So M1G is the main force. M1G is the main force. So you start with M1 as we did before, write M1, write the equation of motion, the main force is M1G minus T equals M1A. Then the other equation, or the second equation, M2, this one, T minus M2G equals M2A. Straightforward, this case. Now if M2 is more than M1, M2 is heavier. M2 is heavier. So M2G is the main force. M2G is the main force. So M2G, the T in the string opposing the weight of M2, M2G minus T is equal to M2A. The other equation, T minus M1G equals M1A. This is the main diagram for this. Let's do examples. Example number, we have a pulley particles of 4 and 2 kilograms connected by a line extensible string. Remember we explained this why it must be light, because we ignore the mass of the string. And extensible means the tension is equal for the whole motion, the same. Pass through over fixed smooth pulley. Find the acceleration of the system. Remember it's one string, so we can say system. The tension in the string, part B. Since 4 is heavier, so 4G is the main force. Write this properly. 4 kilograms like this, explain. 4G minus T equals 4A, equation number 1. Write the equation of motion, or the forces acts on 2 kilograms, it's T minus 2G equals 2A. Once the acceleration simply, my dear students, we add the two equations. We add, so 4G minus 2G, it's 2G equals 6A, 4A plus 2A, 6A, so A is equal to G over 3. If you want the answers in decimals, of course, we can write it in decimals. If you want the answer in decimals, we can write it in decimals. A here is 3.27 meter per second squared. We prefer sometimes to finish our answers in terms of G like this. And this will be more important in the next chapter after this. Dynamics 7 and Dynamics 8. Then we will do statics, that those problems are important. By equation 2 or equation 1, any of the two equations, we can find the value of the tension or magnitude of the tension. So I chose equation 2 because T with positive, it's up to us. So it's just a straightforward step. T minus 2G equals 2A, replace A by its value. So T is equal to 8G divided by 3. Eight times 9.8 over 3, 26.1 newtons. Or you keep it in terms of G like this. Both are right. Example two, you are given a system of two particles connected by a string passed through a pulley like this, 3 kilograms and M. You are given in the question M is less than 3. M is lighter than 3. 3 is heavier. Each particle accelerates. We are given the value of acceleration, 3g over 7. It's the way that he gives us 3g. This I was talking about 2 minutes earlier. If you are given like this in variables, in letters, follow the question. Okay, if the particles accelerate with 3g over 7 meter per second squared, find the tension in the string, find the value of m, find the mass. All right, since 3 is more than m, as he gives us, we are given this, so 3g is the main force. So 3g first equation minus t equals 3 times a, which is given. Solve this for t. So t is equal to 3g minus 9g over 7. So this is 21, making the denominator the same. 21 minus 9 is 12g over 7 newton. To find the value of m, of course, we deal with the second equation. Resolve the forces on the particle of m kilograms. T minus mg, T minus mg equals ma. Just write the value of the tension here, replace the value of the tension. 12g over 7 minus mg is equal to m times a, which is 3g over 7. Now this is your steps, algebraic steps, make x the subject, solve it for m. The easiest way, plus mg there, so mg plus 3mg over 7, over, make the denominator the same, over 7, so this is 7mg plus 3mg, 10mg over 7. Remember, 3, 7 here, yes? And 7 here. And 3, 7 plus g, 3, 10mg over 7. As he asks students, of course, you must be good in, or A level, so maybe, in fractions. Yes? So 10mg over 7 is equal to, let me just write this in more clear way, 7 over 7. So g with g cancel each other. 7 minus 7, 7 with 7 is cancelled. 10m is equal to 12 divided by 10, 1.2 kilograms. Let's move to the to a different case. It's called the horizontal table case. The same idea, but here different diagram. We have a pulley, a string connecting two particles passing over a pulley, fixed smooth pulley, but on one of them lies on horizontal table, like M1 in this diagram, So you had two cases just to help you to write the main diagram, the main equations of motion in any given diagram, it will help. So if the plane or surface that this particle is lying on, smooth in the first case, rough in the second, if it's smooth in both cases, this will move downwards or freely, downwards, vertically downwards. So M2G is the main force. So M2G minus T equals M2A. T, it's the only force acting on the particle. T is equal to M1A. If it's rough, so you have friction. So what will change here? First equation will not change. M2G will go in this direction. M2G since it's freely, unless we are told something else, but in this diagram, it's always moving downwards. By common sense, this will go down. So M2G minus T equals M2A. We have another force now, since the plane or the surface of motion is rough. So T minus FR is equal to M1A. FR equals mu R, where R equals M1G. R equals M1G. Example on this. Two particles of masses 2 and 4 as shown in the diagram here, 2 and 4, connected by a string. The particle of 4 kilograms lies on a smooth horizontal table. The 2 kilograms hangs freely as shown in the figure. Find acceleration in the system. Part A, find the tension in the string in part B. Find the force exerted by the string on the pulley. There is a force here, since, remember the pulley, what's the role of the pulley? Just transfers the tension, transfers. Because of this, always they are in opposite directions. Both, look, tension in all of the cases. They are going or go moves towards, look here, towards, yes, the pulley. All right. So since this hangs freely, so the equation of motion, the main force is 2G. So I write like this, 2 kilograms, be neat and clear. 2G minus T is equal to 2A, first equation. T, it's the only one since it's smooth. So it's the only force acting on this, on the particle of 4 kilograms is T. So second equation is T equals 4A. By adding the two equations, minus T with T will be gone. So 2G is equal to 6A. So A is equal to 3.27 meters per second squared. By replacing, dear great students, A is equal to 3.27 in equation 2. So 4 times A is equal to, in terms of G is 4/3G, 4 times this, or in decimals, 4 times this, you will get 13.1 newtons. There is force by the string of the pulley. First, how do you calculate this force? How do we calculate it? We have a formula, my dear students. We have a formula. Formula of the force. We just write force of the pulley to be simple. Yes, force of the pulley. But it is the force that exerted by the string on the pulley. We can write this force on the pulley. It doesn't matter here. 2t cosine alpha over 2. We calculate this force by 2t cosine alpha over 2. What is alpha? Alpha is always the angle at the edge of the table. At the edge of the table. It might be horizontal, it might be inclined, like we see in the last page or the last part now, in the next few minutes. So alpha is the angle at the edge of the table, at the pulley, near to the pulley. This is alpha in this. In this example, alpha is 90 degrees, is right, because it's horizontal table. So just we write 2 times t cosine alpha over 2, so cosine 45 degrees. By using the calculator, you will get the force on the pulley is 18.5 newtons. Let's move to the last case for today. Inclined plane. As we have horizontal plane, smooth plane and rough, we have the same here. We are familiar with these cases. When we study, finished one particle in dynamics 6 and 5. So what's the difference here? We have a pulley or a string connecting two particles, one on smooth plane, one on rough inclined plane at the angle theta as shown in both diagrams. The equations of motion according to the case given, inclined plane, you will be given. So I chose in the first case, particle in two moving down the plane. Down, it's given when you are signed like this, moving down the plane. In the rough, it's not always, it's an example. It's an example according to what we will be told in the questions. We decide the direction. But for example, I did this up the plane. So according to the given direction, in this case, remember this inclined plane, so we have two components for the weight, m2g cosine theta, the weight, don't forget m2g, the weight. These facts, don't forget them, the weight, m2g, always making 90 degrees to the horizontal, yes? So we have two components, m2g cosine theta, because theta is here, to remind you quickly, and this is the opposite one, m2g sine theta. In this question, m2g sine theta is the main force, minus t, no forces acting other than these, is equal to m2a, t for m1, t is equal to m1g, t minus m1g equals m1a, for particle hangs freely. The same for case 2 or case B, but this surface is rough, so we have friction. And he told us the direction of motion is up the plane. Is up the plane in this case. So, since it's up the plane, so this is the main force in this diagram. M1g is the main force acting on M1. So M1g minus t equals M1a, the first equation. Second equation, t now parallel to the plane, t minus m2g sine theta minus fr, since it's rough, is equal to m2a, and remember friction is equal to mu r, the previous cases, dynamics 5 and 6, r is equal to m2g cosine theta, R is equal to m2g, writing the three equations of motion. Let's do the last example in numbers for now. Example 4. From this given diagram, given that mu is 0.4, the friction of motion, the coefficient of friction is mu is 0.4, the system released from rest, fine. So you are given two particles, this is 4 kilograms, this is 2 kilograms on a rough plane, makes at an angle 30 degrees to the horizontal. find the acceleration of the system. This is the direction of motion, so this is the main force. So we start with, write this, 4 kilograms. 4 kilograms. 4G is the main force, minus T is equal to 4A, equation number one. Question number two, T, which is here, this T, minus FR, minus 2G sine 30. We said we can write minus minus many times before. So if a student watching this video didn't watch the previous ones, watch please the previous ones. They are so helpful and useful to you. So you can write minus minus, or we just do minus plus here, then you put brackets according. You do this, then you put plus. We are free. So T opposing FR and 2G sine theta down the plane is equal to 2A, where FR could be found because we are given mu in the question. So FR is equal to mu R, remember? So mu is given 0.4, and R from the diagram, write everything, resolve everything on the diagram. 2G cosine 30, you will get 6.8 newtons. Just replace 6.8 in the first second equation. So you'll be having first equation 4G minus T. Write them again next to each other like this. Students in M1, they may lose many marks for inconvenience. Dear students, inconvenience, be careful, especially in Excel. So 4G minus T equals 4A, T minus 6.8, which is the friction, minus 9.8, this calculate in the calculator, you get this, is equal to 2A. Use the calculator now by calculating, 4 times 9.8 minus 6.8, dividing by 6, getting A, 3.77 meter per second squared. Choose any equation to find the tension in the string. You want the tension now. I choose equation 1. You are free to choose any one, 2 or 1. 4 times G, 9.8, in this equation, minus T equals 4. Just replace A by its value. Solve it 14 in the calculator. You'll get 24.12 newtons. Force exerted on the pulley by the string. Force the pulley, we said it's 2t cosine alpha over 2. Where's alpha? We said alpha is here. This is at the edge, at the end of the table, next at the pulley. So this is 30, this is right, this is 60. So alpha in this example is 60 degrees. Alpha in this example is 60 degrees. So you just write 2 times the tension that we find times cosine 30 gives you the force on the pulley is 41.8 newtons. Right? After this part you'll be doing past paper problems, like 3-4 problems on dynamics, finishing dynamics, then moving to statics. Then after this you'll be solving harder problems, more common, harder problems. Wishing you the best. Wishing you the best in all your exams, and thank you so much.